Yes.
Okay, sir.
So
Great, great.
basically, yes. So basically, here we have few of my mini project students and Nachiket Deshpande from PCCOE.
Yes,
So Nachiket, I hope you know the classic basic theory of classification.
Yes, sir.
Nachiket?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now Kaushal, what you can do is you and Naman start with explaining what is support vector machine, basic of support vector machine, how it is used for classification,
Okay, sir.
and then what is necessity of optimizing it,
Yes, sir.
and how these optimizers are used to this purpose, so optimization of SVM. So you can explain these all optimizers one by one, and then you can jump back again to the project. So here the
Yes, sir.
basic aim of this meeting is I will ask these students to work upon some more optimizers other than what you are used. Like
Yes,
there
sir.
are few optimizers, new optimizers जे आपण मध्ये डिस्कस केले होते पण त्याच्यावर आपल्याला काही काम करता आलं नाही.
बरोबर सर.
तर जेणेकरून ह्या मुलांना आता ह्या ऑप्टिमायझर्सची माहिती कळली तर मग ते पुढे जाऊन वेगळ्या ऑप्टिमायझर्सवरती काम करतील. ओके,
यस
सो
सर.
यू जस्ट स्टार्ट विथ युअर एक्सप्लेनेशन अँड देन विल सी. ओके, स्टार्ट द रिकॉर्डिंग. ओके, यू हॅव स्टार्टेड इट. ओके, तर नाव सी कौशल,
Yes, sir.
दिस इज नॉट जस्ट अ प्रेझेंटेशन, यू हॅव टू टीच देम, यू हॅव टू
अंडरस्टूड.
एक्सप्लेन. हां, ओके, नाव यू कॅन स्टार्ट. या,
Yes. So, good afternoon. My name is Kaushal Kulkarni. I worked with sir this year. He was our guide for our mini project as well as our BTech project. Our group consisted of me, Naman Bajaj, who's also present, Rohan Ghatpande, and Atharva Kapadia. So, as sir said, I'll begin with support vector machine. So I'll just stop sharing and I'll share another screen so that I can show you an image of support vector machine. That will help me in explaining. Can you see my screen? Is my screen visible?
Yes, screen is visible.
Thank you. So basically, let's begin with support vector machines. Support vector machine is a machine learning tool or a machine learning algorithm which helps us classify two sets of datas into different and distinct classes. Okay. So sometimes we have data sets which are into two particular subset of the superset. So if I give an example just off the top of my head, if there is a data set of people who have a bank account in a bank, okay, and they have specific information about them, like their age, their bank balance, their credit score, etc., etc. Depending on all the parameters, there will be two subset of these groups. One subset will be, for example, one will be eligible for a loan, the other will not be eligible for a loan, right? So we are classifying them into two distinct classes, and we that this is necessary in a banking sector because of course they have to make decisions for whether the loan has to be given or not. So that is just one example. Similarly, in tool condition monitoring, the domain in which we were working on a problem set where we were classifying the tool as healthy or faulty. Okay, so I'll just get into the different classes in which we classified, but as a general overview, we classified the tool into healthy or faulty. Okay, so there are multiple classification algorithms in the in theory that we can apply. Okay, there is KNN, there is SVM, there are LDAs, there are multiple classification algorithms. Out of all those classification algorithms, I would suggest that you would, if you're clueless about what classification algorithms are or what machine learning is or what data processing, all of those basics, I can't cover everything right now, but I would suggest that you should go through some basic material. There's a lot of material out there.
Kaushal, they know what is classification. They have worked on deep learning algorithms actually, but I think not using SVM. So just explain just fundamental of SVM and then go ahead with optimization.
Right. Great. Okay. So, great that you know what classification algorithms are. So SVM is support vector machine. It's a classification algorithm in which the data is classified by the means of a hyperplane. You can see this image right here. Over here, there is a plane that is drawn to distinctly divide the data into class 1 and class 2. So the basic funda or the fundamental is that the gap between both the classes should be maximum. The hyperplane should be positioned in such a manner that the distance between the two distinct classes is maximum. Okay, so that will give us the most optimum position of the plane. So that is the basic fundamental on which support vector machines work. And there is a mathematical algorithm for that. If you're interested, you can go through it. Okay, so with your permission, sir, I'll begin with the basic overview of the project and the optimization. So should I begin with the optimization process?
Yes.
Okay. So, right. So support vector machines basically have two parameters in the mathematical equations. There are two parameters that need to be optimized. So as I told you, there is a mathematical algorithm, and during the algorithm, we have to supply or give the SVM model two values, which is C and gamma. You can see here. Okay, so C and gamma. Yeah, so there are two values or two parameters called C and gamma. C is the error penalty and gamma is the kernel function. So depending on these two values, the most optimum value gives the best accuracy. So depending on the value that you give C and gamma, the accuracy of classification and the performance of your model depends heavily on those two parameters, right? So what generally we do, if you're a noob or a newbie and you're getting into machine learning for the first time or you're building your first SVM model, what you'll do is you'll give random C and gamma values. That's what we generally do. And by trial and error, you come up to the best accuracy and you're happy with the model. Okay. But in the industry, or if you want to do it properly, you can't just randomly assign values. So you have to optimize and find the best value for C and gamma to find the best accuracy for your SVM model. Okay. So this is where optimization as a whole comes into the picture. When we say optimization, it also can be interpreted as hyperparameter tuning. If you've done deep learning, you would know what that is. But of course, hyperparameter tuning and optimization go on the same similar lines, right? So one of the basic hyperparameter tuning methods or an optimization method is grid search CV. So that is the first optimization tool that we use. What is grid search CV now? Grid search CV is nothing but, for example, if we have C and gamma, we assign a range of values for C and gamma. Okay. So we assign a range of value. For example, C will be given a range from 0 to 100 with a step of 10. So C is given a list of values from 0 to 100 such that the step is 10. I mean 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, so on up to 100. Similarly, gamma will also be given a range of values, for example, from 0.1 to 1 with a step of 0.1. So that is nothing but 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, so on. So what grid search CV does is it creates a grid of values of C cross gamma, a 2 cross 2 matrix of all the values of C and gamma in the list that we have provided it. Okay. And it will individually apply all of those permutation and combinations for C and gamma. Basically, all the elements in the matrix will be tried out by a trial and error method such that all the models with those values are trained and made, and they are tested. And the one with the best accuracy is considered the best model, and the parameters are given accordingly. Right. So that is Gritzert CV. But then Gritzert CV has a very has a blatant fault or a blatant, you know, problem with it. That is that you need to know the range of values to give Gritzert CV. You should know what the range of C and gamma are to get the best accuracy. And when you're starting out, you might not know what those values are, or it's just not the best way of doing it. Plus, it is extremely expensive because there is a lot of, you know, it's very expensive for the system because you have to train n cross n models and you have to test them, and then you will get the result. So it is slow and it is very expensive. Not in terms of money, but in terms of memory, of course. Before I come to SMO, I'll just explain the other kind of optimization algorithms there are. So we have a lot of mathematical algorithms that are used to optimize the parameters for SVMs. So there are tons of them, tons. As Sir was saying, that we only could test a certain optimization algorithms. But there are hundreds and hundreds of them out there. In fact, people come up with papers and methods every year. There are tons of papers on optimization algorithms, and these can be used for all machine learning or most of the machine learning algorithms out there. So before I come to SMO, I'll just explain meta heuristic algorithms. Meta heuristic algorithms are, again, so basically before I get into this will be a little confusing. Okay, so if you have any doubts, if I'm going fast, you can. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Don't mention that na linear, quadratic, cubic, and Gaussian. The fitting SVM ma the kaise karta thoda sa graphs nahi dakhu sakta par mujhe ko karna hai today se gada hyper parameter tuning wagare kare. Google na ja.
Yes, sir.
Ani linear, quadratic, cubic, and Gaussian kaise fit karta SVM ma the. Ye thoda sa dakhao. आणि मग देन म्हणजे दे विल अंडरस्टँड सी एन गामा आणि मग त्याचं
येस सर आय एम सो सॉरी मी माझं स्क्रीन दुसरं शेअर करत होतो मी दाखवलंच नाही ते आय एम सो सॉरी मी दुसऱ्या पीपीटी वरती शिफ्ट झालेलो मी ते शेअर करायचं विसरलो ओ माय बॅड आय थिंक नाउ इट इज विजिबल येस सर तुम्ही म्हणत होता सर लिनियर quadratic and Gaussian
linear quadratic Gaussian and cubic linear quadratic cubic and Gaussian ha graph milun jate tula lagel
hello sir bol puchu kya sir
bol
सर ये एक चीज बोला सर गैमा आपने बोला गैमा के अंदर हम फंक्शन यूज कर रहे हैं सो फंक्शन वो कैसे मींस उसको बाइफर्केट कैसे कर मतलब हम पूरा का पूरा अपना डेटा सेट उसमें ये फंक्शन में हम लोग पुट कर रहे हैं सर मींस आपने बोला गैमा वो गैमा के अंदर हम फंक्शन तो वो गैमा एक कर्नल फंक्शन हो गया मींस हमारा
यस यस करेक्ट
सो ऑप्टिमाइजर मींस और यही हमारा ऑप्टिमाइजर भी रहा मतलब
सो if I may, sir.
Yes, so, yes. Go ahead.
So basically, SVM is a function of C and gamma. Okay. So SVM is a function, or SVM is the model to which we are fitting the data, and we are getting a function. And in that algorithm, we optimize C and gamma. So C and gamma are the parameters or the values on which the SVM depends. So they are dependent. SVM is dependent on C and gamma. Okay, so हम लोग क्या करते हैं कि हम लोग पहले ट्रेन करते हैं ठीक है एंड ट्रेन करते वक्त यू हैव टू डिफाइन अ मॉडल सो व्हेन यू डिफाइन अ मॉडल वी डिफाइन द वैल्यूज ऑफ C एंड गामा फॉर विच द मॉडल इज बिल्ट तो वो एल्गोरिदम में सी एन गामा का वैल्यू इनपुट होता है एंड उसके अकॉर्डिंगली वो एल्गोरिदम परफॉर्म होता है और मॉडल क्रिएट होता है. आई होप दैट सॉल्व्स योर प्रॉब्लम. सो यू सेड कि इट इज अ कर्नल फंक्शन, यू आर राइट, बट वी डोंट, जो ट्रेनिंग डेटा है वो हम लोग गामा में नहीं डालते. सर आपण हे म्हणत होतो का डिसिजन बाउंड्रीज, आय कम टू दॅट सर. एसव्हीएमचं मी एकदा परत नीट एक्सप्लेन करतो कारण ते मला मिळत नाही आहे, आणि एकदा नमन पण असेल तर ही ऑल्सो पिच इन लेटर ऑन फॉर एसव्हीएम.
कौशल, ऍक्च्युअली ऍक्च्युअली कौशल, इट इज सिंपल, आय टेल यू, इट इज सेम
यस
एज रिग्रेशन विच वी हॅव डन इन न्यूमरिकल मेथड.
यस
सो वेन वी फिट अ स्ट्रेट लाईन इट इज कॉल्ड एज और अ स्ट्रेट लाइन और एनी पॉलिनोमियल और यू नो क्यूबिक इक्वेशन द सेम फंडा इज यूज हियर.
यस सर.
Yes. So based on that, they have defined kernel functions. It can be either polynomial, it can be linear, it can be cubic, or it can be a Gaussian.
Yes, sir.
So basically, in Gaussian, which I have like read during SMO SVM implementation. So during training of Gaussian kernel function, we need particularly regularization factor, that is the gamma, that means the width and height of that bell-shaped curve, and based
right.
on various values of those based on various values of those bell-shaped curve, we find the best fitted model. And of course, this is all depends on type of data distribution which you have as an input. So
right.
you can go
right.
ahead.
Okay sir, thank you sir. So I hope that solves the doubt that you had, and I'll just move on. So this is what I was showing. This is what I was showing. I didn't share my screen properly. That's why I was not. I was on this slide, and I'll just move on to meta-heuristic algorithms. Okay. So the basic agenda of our project, or the main thing in which we focus, was meta heuristic algorithms for optimizing the value of CN gamma, right? So now we know that what C is, what gamma is, and now we know that we have to find the best value. I told you about grid search CV, where you give a range of values, and by permutation combination, it's a brute force method of analyzing the best parameters and you get a value, but that is not the best way of doing it. So what meta heuristic algorithm is are, so they are basically algorithms which mimic certain activities or things that happen in nature. They mimic the randomness and the events that happen in nature. For example, how a lion goes to hunt, or an elephant goes to drink water, or a cat goes to attack a mouse, or how we humans interact. So this is kind of a tangent to the entire process or of what we were talking about. But what happens is these scientists or researchers, they have taken all these basic activities in nature and they have modeled those activities into certain algorithms, which when performed gives you the best value of the parameters which you input into the algorithm. In our case, it is CN gamma. So I just reiterate what happens. These algorithms are modeled on things that happen in nature. You will understand further of about the different kind of algorithms there are, but they mimic what happens in the nature, and those individual parameters which we've inputted into the algorithm are optimized. Okay. So again, the math for this is quite complex, and you have to go through each and every algorithm or optimizer to go through the math and understand what is happening with each parameter in each iteration. So that is within the scope of this project. That is what we did, of course. But of course, I'll not go through every optimizer and explain the math, because that will take a lot of time. So what I'll give here is just, I'll give you the logic of what actually happens in the optimizer and how that logic is used to get the best values of C and gamma. So I'll begin with the first, okay, I'll first explain the different kind of meta-heuristic algorithms. There are basically two basic broad classification of meta-heuristic algorithms. One is nature-inspired, the other is non-nature-inspired. For nature-inspired, they are further classified into evolutionary, physics-based, swarm intelligence-based, human-based, and chemical-based. They are self-explanatory in a certain sense. Evolutionary are modeled on the evolutionary cycle of, you know, life. Physics are based on physical phenomena which occur in the nature. Swarm intelligence is based on how swarms interact with each other, herds, swarms interact with each other. Humans are based on human interaction, and chemical based are based on the chemical reactions that happen in nature. So moving on, I'll first explain multiverse optimizer. Multiverse optimizer is basically inspired from on three entities: black holes, white holes, and wormholes. So the basic idea or the basic logic is that we create n random universes, okay? And in these n random universes, in each iteration, an object from high inflation rate universe moves towards a low inflation rate universe through the means of a white hole or a black hole. And simultaneously, all universes experience random teleportation of objects headed for the best universe via wormholes. So what this says is basically there are two phases to this optimizer. The first phase is that a universe from high inflation rate goes to a universe to a low inflation rate with the means of a black hole or a wormhole, a black hole or a white hole, and an object from one universe goes to another universe, which is the best universe, by the means of a wormhole. So now this is an analogy. Okay, you have to understand this is not what actually happens in the algorithm. We assign the values of C, gamma, or whatever parameters that we want to optimize to these hypothetical objects that we have defined. And in this case, the best scenario is for the object or the parameter to head to the best universe, which has the best particular value. Basically, it converges to the best value. And the means in which it converges is the logic that I've given you right now of universes going from a higher inflation rate to a lower inflation rate, right? And this is again based on physics. So this is a physical meta-heuristic model. Then moving on to the next one, which I'll explain, is Dragonfly algorithm. Dragonfly algorithm is a swarm intelligence based algorithm, and it is modeled on the behavior of dragonflies and how they interact with each other in a herd or in a swarm. So they have basically two behaviors. One is exploration and the other one is exploitation. There are two phases to the optimization. In the first phase, which is exploration, the dragonflies in small herds fly small distances to find food and to attract flying prey. In the second phase of exploitation, a big cluster of dragonflies migrate over long distances to distract the enemies or distract the animals which hunt them. So based on these two phases, which is exploration and exploitation, the parameters converge to the best value. Okay. And again, for each mathematical algorithm, for a meta-heuristic algorithm, the variables are based on the behavior of that particular animal, which is the dragonfly. So the for example, in a dragonfly algorithm, there are five variables or five parameters which we can optimize simultaneously, which is affinity for food, distraction from the enemy, separation, alignment, and cohesion. So again, as I told you, this is an analogy. We are not exactly optimizing these values. We are optimizing our parameters based on the algorithm given by dragonfly. Okay. So the next one I'll explain is grasshopper optimization algorithm, or GOA. It again, it's similar to dragonfly, as in it is a swarm-based meta-heuristic algorithm, but it is modeled on how grasshoppers interact with each other. So it is basically modeled on the life cycle of a grasshopper. A grasshopper in its entire life cycle has two phases. One is an infant stage or an adolescent stage that is called nymph stage, right? And the second stage is called adulthood. So in the first phase of optimization, which is the nymph phase, the convergence takes place in shorter paces, in smaller steps. And when we head on to the adulthood, which is the second phase, the convergence takes place in bigger steps. So we converge faster to the desired value. Now moving on to sine cosine algorithm. Sine cosine algorithm is a non-nature inspired meta-heuristic algorithm. It is a mathematical algorithm, and it's nothing but basically the position of each object gets modified or gets updated by using a sine or a cosine function. So in each iteration, we have a basic mathematical formula in which in each iteration, the new position of the parameter is assigned to a sine or a cosine function. And by using this algorithm, iteratively, we converge to a value, right? Then we have SSA, which is singular spectrum analysis. Singular spectrum analysis is developed using time domain principal component analysis, or PCA, for univariate time series. So PCA is a very common technique that electronics and telecommunication engineers use to decompose a signal and to basically remove the noisy parts. So this algorithm is modeled on how that particular process takes place, or how PCA takes place or is executed in electronics, in the electronics field. Based on the methodology of that particular phenomena, SSA meta heuristic algorithm is developed. Right. So moving on, we go on to Gray-Wolf optimization algorithm. Now we come back to nature inspired algorithms. This is again a nature inspired algorithm, and it is modeled on the hunting behavior of a gray wolf. So gray wolves, they hunt in packs or in group of wolves. They hunt in packs or groups, and there is a hierarchy of wolves. Okay. So the hierarchy is in such a way that alpha are the leaders or alpha wolves, then beta are subordinate to alpha, delta wolves are subordinate to beta, and omega wolves are the weakest wolves, right? So whenever they head out to hunt, and hunting in our use case is optimization. So whenever they head out for hunting, or whenever we head out as wolves to optimize our problem, the parameters which are assigned to alpha, beta, delta lead the optimization process, and omega is the lowest ranking and it follows alpha, beta, and delta iteratively. So finally, these three or four groups head towards the hunt and they hunt their prey. And once that takes place, we converge onto a value. So we get the values for our parameters. Then we have BAT algorithm. This is modeled on the behavior of echolocation technique that bats use to locate and position themselves. So it is based on that phenomena. And in this analogy, bats are assigned three variables. One is the yeah sorry Yeah, they are assigned three variables. One is the position of the bat, second is the velocity of the bat, and third is the frequency vector, the frequency of the echolocation call that the bat gives. And based on these three variables, these three variables are iteratively modified and they converge onto a value for our parameter, which we get, of course. There's an interesting fact about this algorithm. In this, only the frequency vector, which is the third variable, is optimized iteratively. So it is also called a frequency tuning algorithm. Then CSO, which is cat swarm optimization, is modeled on cats. This is the last one that we used. We used 8 meta heuristic algorithms, out of which the cat algorithm, or the optimization algorithm, was modeled on how cats behave. So basically, according to the author of the paper that proposed cat swarm optimization, cats have two behavioral aspects to their life. One is when they sleep, and the other time when they move. So when they sleep, or when they are just sitting and docile, they are tracing. They have a high level of consciousness and they are extremely aware of what is happening in their surroundings. So at that moment, although they are not moving, they are tracing the entire surroundings for prey. And once they finalize onto the prey, which is our final value, which we want, once we find that value, the optimization algorithm, or the cat, moves on to the tracking phase, in which it starts tracking the prey. And when it finally catches the prey is when we get the final value. So this is what we did. These are the algorithms that we used. And of course, this will be a little confusing. And to be honest, it is still confusing to us and me, Naman, and all of us, because this is for the first time we are using this. And meta-heuristic algorithms have come into the picture since 2010. And they're extremely new, they're very current, that this is something that is happening right now at this juncture. And yes, it is a little confusing. So if you have any doubts, you can go ahead and ask any doubts before I go head on. Right, so
Austin?
Yes, sir.
Go ahead, no problem.
So I would just recommend that if you want, we'll just share all the papers that we have, and you can just go through all the papers. All the individual algorithms have their own novel paper, and they're extremely interesting. They're very interesting, very well explained. So you will get a better idea of what meta-heuristic algorithms are as such. Sir, ata kai explain karu? Feature selection explain karu ka kai man jata? Algorithms tam se he hote?
Yes, yes. Naman ani tu ata results ani thoda sa program. Actually, before going to the feature selection and results.
Hello, sir.
Naman ni sir, MATLAB madhe thoda sa coding explain kela.
The recurrent neural network.
Isn't it?
Yes.
So that part no, we'll sir. Do later. Let us finish this part. Yes. So Naman.
No, sir. Sir Fahad wants to say something, sir.
Naman, aaye ka Naman?
Yes, sir.
So now you can explain MATLAB part. Whatever you
sir,
have
actually,
done.
The meta-heuristic part of the code is too complex that I can
explain. Not coding part, but just overview. Results कैसे compute किए वगैरह थोड़ा सा.
Kaushal, can you take it to those MATLAB screenshots?
हाँ लेता हूँ.
हाँ सो दिस इज़ वन वे यू कैन वर्क विथ MATLAB. दिस ऑब्वियसली वी डिड नॉट यूज फॉर मेटाहेरिस्टिक एल्गोरिथम्स, बट यू कैन यूज इट फॉर डिफरेंट एस वी एम विथ लीनियर कर्नल, क्वाड्रेटिक कर्नल, क्यूबिक कर्नल्स, बिकॉज दिस आर दी इनबिल्ट कर्नल्स अवेलेबल इन MATLAB फॉर एस वी एम, एंड दिस आर दी इनबिल्ट एल्गोरिथम्स अवेलेबल फॉर क्लासिफिकेशन. And so what you see here is you input a CSV file which has the initial rows as all the it is basically all the features that you have extracted, and the last column will be the condition that you know it is it A, B, C, D or E. And once you import this, you have to select if you want to do cross validation, whatever number of folds depending on your data. If you want to do holdout validation, where you can keep some data reserved to test your trained model, or if you do not want to validate at all. Kaushal, next slide. So this is a screenshot of what the code for metaheuristic algorithms based SVM looked like. So this essentially covers all 8 metaheuristic algorithms. All you have to do is set which algorithms are to be trained, are to be used. We have to set some initial parameters like number of iterations for each fold and a few other values. Here you can see that there are many MATLAB files which are called one by one. There is a file called select features. So it essentially selects features. Here selecting feature also means that we are selecting the value for gamma and c, because those are also our features. Then we can set the EVO details, exactly what we want. We can read the CSV file. This file is essentially read from this particular MATLAB code. Then you can initiate the evolutionary algorithms, that is done using this particular MATLAB file. Of course, the main file that I have shown a screenshot of, the EVO SVM, you have to just work with this particular file and it will interact with all the other files. And the CSV files that you can see towards the bottom left, those are the output CSV files that we receive. One is a summary file, so it has all the summary that what is the average accuracy, average precision recall, then number of features used, RMS error, average error, and all that. Then you have parameters, the parameters that you set initially. Then you have convergences. So this is iteration wise accuracy that you get. So you can plot this and see if the accuracies converge, so that you can, if you can use it for comparison. Then you see best individual. This file basically has the best individual fold results, fold wise results. So say when we are training all these 8 algorithms, so for MVO, for each fold, what were the statistics, what was the accuracy, precision, recall, and errors and everything. So this has fold wise results. Then we have average convergences, so these are just averaged of the main file. And then we have all results. This again summarizes all the results. So these are all the output files that we get. And yeah, question next slide, please. This is a screenshot while it was running. So you can see the command window that you'll keep getting outputs like cross validation accuracy. And this is sort of important because this runs for around 3-4 hours. And it is important to know if it's running at all. So you keep getting this output. That's it. Kaushal, should I explain the results or you have told me the results?
कर दे जल्दी, कोई प्रॉब्लम होगा तो मैं करता हूँ ना.
यस 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 यस, गो अहेड.
सो दिस इज द रिजल्ट फॉर ट्रैक वन, दैट वाज द यूज ऑफ लीनियर डिस्क्रिमिनेंट एनालिसिस फॉर क्लासिफिकेशन.
वी हैड अ सिमिलर डेटा एंड यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज अ कन्वर्जेंस कर्व. The y-axis is classification error, so we have a convergence at some value near 0.13, and this is one of the inbuilt MATLAB tools, so there you can use discriminant analysis, and this was in optimization mode. That means it will optimize all the discriminant analysis models it has and its hyperparameters. So we got linear discriminant analysis as the best classifier. And this is the convergence part. Kaushal, next slide. These are just the confusion matrices for the best classifier that we received. Next slide. This is for holdout validation method. The previous one was for tenfold cross validation. So with holdout validation, we received a higher accuracy, and again we got a linear discriminant analysis as the best classifier, and this is the convergence curve. These are the confusion matrices for the best holdout, the best classifier using holdout validation method, and the accuracy was 93.3%, whereas for tenfold cross validation it was 87-88%. So we have an increase of 5% approximately. This is a table showing the accuracies using different holdout percentages. We ran it from 20 to 50 with a step of 2.5%, and there is no particular trend that we could observe in using the holdout percentage, and we saw that 25% holdout gives the maximum accuracy. So it is more or less a trial and error. These are the results for track 2, that is for the meta-heuristic algorithms based SVM. And these are 8 algorithms that you can see. These are all the convergence curves, but this time we have plotted fitness or the accuracy. Last time it was the classification error, so it is exactly the opposite. And again, you can see that all the algorithms have converged essentially. And particularly, if you see the algorithm BAT, so it converges after 70th iteration. So if you run 50 iterations, then you lack some accuracy on BAT. You'll miss that accuracy. So that's why it is very important to see if the accuracies are converged. Next slide, please. These are the detailed results for the accuracy, recall precision, errors, number of features used. And we see that SCA has an accuracy of 92%. With the features, number of features used as 7.3. So it uses the least number of features and gives the maximum accuracy, the maximum recall and precision as well, and the least errors. Next slide. Hello.
Now you are now audible. You are going. You are not audible, Nama.
These are the results for SMO based SVM, and we can see that the accuracy is again 92%. That was the maximum we received through meta heuristic algorithms as well. But the number of features. Facing
You're not audible, Naman. Naman?
कौशल तू तू एक्सप्लेन कर.
हाँ हो सकता म्हणजे मला सगळ्यांनाच ऐकून येते ना
कन्फ्युजन मॅट्रिक्स आणि बाकीच्या गोष्टी यांना माहिती आहेत त्याने काम केलंय त्याच्यावर
तर मग तर झालंय सर. हा ही इज एक्सप्लेन्ड इट मोस्टली बट मागचा जो स्लाइड होता एक सेकंड SMO चं हे रिझल्ट आहे सर की प्रत्येक क्लास वाईज दिस इज अ कन्फ्युजन मॅट्रिक्स आफ्टर ऑल तर तेच ह्यांनी ग्राफिकल मेथड मध्ये दाखवलेलं आणि ओव्हरऑल ऍक्युरसी 92% आलेली आहे. मग ग्रिडचं CV ऍज आय एक्सप्लेन त्याचा पण हे रिझल्ट आहे त्यात 90% ऍक्युरसी आलेलं आम्हाला. तर आम्ही वी हॅड जस्ट कम्पेअर्ड SMO ग्रिडचं CV अँड ऑल दी मेटा ह्युरिस्टिक अल्गोरिदम सो वी कॅन सी दॅट हिअर. This is a three-dimensional view of accuracy versus recall versus precision. Tar yat purna overview milto ki how all of these performed individually. So we can see that for almost all the meta heuristic algorithms we got a recall of 100 and the accuracy varied with SCA getting the best accuracy. And similarly grid search CV and SMO we had a good accuracy SMO of 92 and grid search CV of 90 but we had a lower recall and precision value. Precision was approximately 94 and recall for SMO was approximately 84 85. So hey asa ami plot karun just to visualize what was the best. So SCA of course is the best out of all of this. सर कंक्लुजन तेच आहे म्हणजे वी हॅड ट्रॅक टू अँड ट्रॅक वन. सो ट्रॅक वन वॉज विथ युझिंग LDA अँड दॅट इज बेसिक व्हेरी बेसिक एक्सपेरिमेंट दॅट वी हॅड डन बट द मेन फोकस ऑफ आवर प्रोजेक्ट वॉज SVM विथ मेटा ह्युरिस्टिक अल्गोरिदम्स SMOs अँड ग्रिड सर्च CV अँड कम्पेअरिंग दीज 8 अल्गोरिदम्स प्लस SMO अँड ग्रिड सर्च CV वी गॉट दॅट साइन कोसाइन अल्गोरिदम which is a non-nature based meta-heuristic algorithm gave us the best accuracy of 92% with a recall and precision value of 100%. So that is for track 2 and that is what we would like to focus on. Of course now sir is saying that you will look into other optimization algorithms so you can deploy different machine learning models and try out different type optimization algorithms. Sir Atha, next can I explain karu?
Yes, fine. Fine. Now we can stop.
Feature selection, should I go through that once?
हाँ जर सांगितलं तर बरं होईल म्हणजे त्यांना एक थोडस बिकॉज दे नो ओनली डिसिजन ट्री मेथड टू सिलेक्ट द फीचर्स.
फीचर मेटा ह्युरिस्टिक्स वापरून वेगळ्या पद्धतीने करू शकतो.
येस येस
हो सर चालेल हा एकदा करतो. सो our features. The main part is feature selection. So for feature selection, for track one we used Weka and in Weka we used the ranker method to rank all the different features and the different attributes. We used ranker with in conjunction with info gain attribute eval. So what that does is basically each feature, what gain of information does it provide to the actual model? It evaluates that and that attribute is ranked in a descending order of preference. So I'll just go to the next slide and you'll understand. So we extracted all these different 13 different attributes, which is mean, sum, standard deviation, etc. You can see. And what ranker method on Weka does is it ranks all the attributes or the features in a descending order of preference. So we can see that this is from a range of 0 to 1. So mean gives us the best possible, is the best possible feature, because it adds the most information, or the information gain because of mean is the maximum. So using this, what we do is basically mod, skewness, minimum and count. They don't contribute to the information gain. So we can just remove them. And by removing them, what happens is the model becomes less complicated, less expensive, and the runtimes are smaller. So this is what we did for track one. And in track two, for SMO and grid search CV, we followed the similar process, which was information gain and ranker's method on Weka. But for the feature selection in meta heuristic algorithms, optimized algorithms, we did feature selection in a different method. For that, what we did, as you guys remember, that C and gamma were the two parameters that we were optimizing, right? So along with that, what meta heuristics algorithms do, or what we did in particular, is that we assigned each feature a particular value from 0 to 1. For example, let us assume that there are 5 features or 10 features. Each of those 10 features were given a particular random value from 0 to 1. And these values were then optimized by taking all these individual 10 features as additional parameters for the meta heuristic algorithm. So instead of 2 parameters, we had 12 parameters. 2 were C and gamma, which were for the SVM, and the 10 were the other features that we wanted to optimize. So, for example, if the optimized value for mode comes out to 0.001 or something, then the contribution of mode to the actual feature is minimal. So it will automatically get deselected. This is how this happens in an iterative fashion. And then all the after the optimization or the algorithm takes place, the model is trained with the features that are selected, and we get the best accuracy. This is visualized by using confusion matrix, as we saw in the results. So feature selection for the second track, or using meta heuristic algorithms, is quite interesting and is a little different from what we used in LDA or in other methods, such as decision tree. Also, we can we use Weka, so it's different from that also. That is feature selection. Then I think that Azun. अजून काही एक्सप्लेन करू का सर? कारण आता डेटा कलेक्शन अँड ऑल तर स्टँडर्ड आहे. आपण
नाही नाही ते ठीक आहे, दॅट इज ओके. डेटा कलेक्शन दे हॅव ऑल्सो वर्क ऑन टूल कंडिशन मॉनिटरिंग, सो दे आर अवेअर ऑफ इट. ओके, थँक्यू कौशल.
थँक्यू.
नाउ दे विल आय विल सेंड देम सम न्यू अल्गोरिदम्स, न्यू ऑप्टिमायझर मेटा हेरिस्टिक बेस्ड. And now they will start working on it.
Yes, sir. All the best to them.
Okay.
And
yes. Thank you.
Thanks, Kaushal.
Thank you. All the best to you all.
Thank you so much.
Enjoy your last year in college.
Yeah.
Thank you. Bye.
लीव करना ना और सिद्धार्थ. हाँ, रिप्लाई भी नहीं.